After a season that's brought plenty of consistency and that long unbeaten run in early 2018, Tottenham Hotspur's recent performances have left the fans, players and manager a bit deflated. Spurs were the Premier League's only unbeaten team in 2018 before their defeat to Manchester City in April. Since then, and perhaps since the win at Chelsea a fortnight before that, Mauricio Pochettino's men have struggled to find their groove again. Plenty of theories have been put forwards from fans and the media as to why Tottenham have let their big lead in fourth place over Chelsea shrink to just 2 points ahead of the final two games of the season. We're going to take a look at them all and try to work out which ones hold up and which ones don't. The dejected Spurs players after Jake Livermore's winner tiredness. Tottenham finished their last campaign in great form and showed no signs of the late-season lethargy normally associated with Pochettino's teams, with the Argentine pushing them hard from the first day of pre-season until the last day in May. But this season certain players look tired, and much of it probably comes down to Pochettino's lack of rotation over the season this time around. Injuries have played their part, as have players just not being good enough to earn the manager's trust. Danny Rose's injury woes and Pochettino not believing Kyle Walker-Peters is ready yet means Ben Davies has played far more than he should have. The same applies to Harry Kane, who looks drained, with Fernando Llorente never having proved to be an effective replacement when he's come into the team. The injuries to Harry Winks and Victor Wanyama have meant that Eric Dier and Moussa Dembele have played more often than Pochettino probably would have liked, with the latter in particular struggling in recent weeks. Then there is the manager's over-reliance on Christian Eriksen, with no natural replacement for the Dane who dictates Tottenham's play. Verdict: fatigue certainly looks to be a viable reason. Did he touch it? Image: Roland Harrison, AFP, Getty Images. Harry Kane's goal claim: he's destroyed the team's harmony, and he's not thinking of the team, shrieked certain sections of the Tottenham faithful in the world of punditry after the striker claimed that second goal against Stoke. Spurs have certainly looked out of sorts since that match, although it could be said that their struggles begin with that match, not afterwards. To say that it's all Harry Kane's fault for claiming a goal that he felt he touched into the net is wide of the mark. Tottenham players were not affected by it, in fact many of them found their reaction funny, not least Eriksen himself, a man who is as happy with an assist as he is a goal. He has laid the banter on thick for Kane in a couple of videos for the club's official social media channels since. Verdict: this Tottenham team is tight and none of the players were bothered that Kane claimed the goal. Mauricio Pochettino looks on during the semi-final defeat. Pochettino's decisions. The manager has come under fire in recent weeks with all the regular bugbears from the fans amplified after defeats. Team selections, substitutions, who comes on and when, his relationships with certain players and his apathy towards the FA Cup have all been decried across social media. Some of it comes down to the usual fun of being a football fan, being happy with a team selection before the match and criticizing it afterwards, but some certainly comes down to a young manager still learning his trade and making the odd mistake along the way as a player would. The players Pochettino has been putting out on the pitch have been more than capable of doing the job in recent matches, but they haven't done the job. The manager's attitude towards the FA Cup was probably too honest. His logic in saying winning it would not change the club is sound up to a point, but it ignores the winning feeling such an event can instill in bigger sides as part of their journey, and his attitude certainly seemed at odds to the players' views. The freezing out of Toby Alderweireld has not helped at times, and his late substitutions can mean he's reactive rather than proactive and gives the likes of Lucas Moura a little time to impress or get into the flow of the game. Verdict: Pochettino is still learning his trade, and like all managers he'll make mistakes, but the players out on the pitch have failed to do their job in recent weeks, particularly in throwing away that FA Cup semi-final. Fernando Llorente's squad depth. One accusation levied against Tottenham is that they don't have a strong enough squad to compete with their Premier League rivals. The squad certainly have no replacements of comparable quality to challenge Harry Kane, Christian Eriksen or Hugo Lloris, but in terms of the overall squad strength, Tottenham actually have a stronger squad than when they finished second last season. The problem has been injuries. Toby Alderweireld, Victor Wanyama, Danny Rose, Harry Winks, Eric Lamella and Moussa Dembele have all struggled with injuries at points during the season, meaning the squad has been stretched despite its greater overall quality. Verdict: this holds up in terms of not having a decent striker and playmaker backup, but not in terms of the overall squad quality. Tottenham chairman Daniel Levy. Daniel Levy's pay packet. Another theory put out there is that the Tottenham players were so outraged when they found out that the club's chairman Daniel Levy had been handed a £6.013 million pay packet last year, up from £2.843 million the previous year, that the harmony within the squad was destroyed as the players wondered why they were getting paid comparatively low wages to their rivals at other clubs. Again, the dates match up with Tottenham's poor form, but in reality, is it something that's really like to affect how the players perform on the pitch? The Spurs players are paid the best bonuses in the Premier League and are rewarded for their good displays. Levy's payout was the same, with the figure containing a backdated pay rise and performance-related bonuses, with some of those also backdated, for his work on the new stadium, sponsorship deals and the training ground. Verdict: this one doesn't seem like a legitimate reason, and apparently the players were not affected by the news within the club's financial statement. Mauricio Pochettino mentality, bottling it, choking, Spursy, they're all terms that have been thrown at Tottenham before and during Pochettino's reign. In terms of the league, the phrases seem harsh when they're now regularly finishing above teams with much bigger financial power. However, they do apply with the club's issue in closing out major knockout matches, as they have shown against Juventus and United this season. Recent weeks have also brought back the old Tottenham habit of failing to capitalize on other teams' slip-ups with blunt performances against teams that, on paper, should be cast aside. But to say this team has no winning mentality and can't deal with big matches is unfair. The victories against Real Madrid, Chelsea, Arsenal, Liverpool, United and Borussia Dortmund this season have shown otherwise. The problem at the moment with the mentality is one Pochettino told Football London about on Saturday that the team seemed to think the job was done after that victory at Stamford Bridge. That the pressure is back on might actually kickstart Spurs into action in these final two games. Verdict: there's definitely been a mentality issue in recent weeks, but it's been more one of a team already thinking ahead to the summer and the World Cup when the job wasn't done yet. Keep up to date with the latest news, features and exclusive from Football London via the free Football London app for iPhone and Android. Available to download from the App Store and